Remember the covenant. When blood binds two people together, there is a covenant in operation, and there are certain principles that govern that covenant. The blood covenant is a very deep covenant that cannot be broken without a consequence following. There are certain things that should be done and things that should never be done by one party of a covenant to the other. If you have a brother or sister with whom you share the same parents, you know there is a covenant between you two because the same blood runs through your veins. Also, as a child of God, you have a covenant with all other children of God because we were all purchased by the same blood of Jesus. There is a brotherly covenant among us all as believers, and because of this, there are things that we should do to one another and there are things that we should never do to each other. Abraham and Lot were related by blood. In Genesis 13, when Abraham decided that it was better for he and Lot to be separated, he asked Lot to choose where he wanted to go. One would have expected Lot to give reverence to Abraham, since Abraham was the older man, and to ask Abraham to be the first to choose. Or at least he should have been humble enough to reserve the first part of the land for his uncle, and then he should have chosen the other part. But he didn't do that. Verses 10 and 11 say, "And Lot lifted up his eyes and beheld all the plain of Jordan, that it was well watered everywhere, even as the garden of the Lord. Then Lot chose him all the plain of Jordan." Then in chapter 14, there was a war, and Lot and his household were taken captive, and Abraham heard of it. If many Christians today were in Abraham's shoes, they would say, "Yes, I knew the Lord would catch up with him sooner or later. He chose the best place. Now he's in trouble. God has vindicated me." Abraham did not do that. Verse 14 of that chapter says, "And when Abraham heard that his brother was taken captive, he armed his trained servants and pursued them unto Dan." Lot acted selfishly towards Abraham. Yet, when he was in trouble, Abraham put his life and the lives of his servants in danger to go and rescue him. What about the time in Genesis 18 when the Lord revealed to Abraham that he wanted to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, where Lot was living? Abraham took it upon himself to intercede for the land because he could not bear to see Lot get destroyed. Abraham never forgot nor broke the brotherly covenant for any reason. What about you, son or daughter of Abraham? Keeping the brotherly covenant entails loving your brothers and sisters sincerely from your heart, forgiving them when they offend you, forgetting whatever they have done against you, watching out for their interests, defending them, interceding for them, helping them, and so on. Do not listen to gossips about your brother. Do not wish him evil, and do not envy him. Do not condemn the weak brother, but rather pray for him, encourage him, strengthen him. Galatians 6:2 says we should bear one another's burdens. Also, 1 John 3:17 says, "But whoso hath this world's good, and seeth his brother have need, and shutteth up his bowels of compassion from him, how dwelleth the love of God in him?" You have to watch out for your brethren in every area of life. What is the consequence of forgetting or breaking the brotherly covenant? Amos chapter 1, verses 9 to 11. "Thus saith the Lord, for three transgressions of Tyrus, and for four, I will not turn away the punishment thereof, because he delivered up the whole captivity to Edom, and remembered not the brotherly covenant. But I will send a fire on the wall of Tyrus, which shall devour the palaces thereof. Thus saith the Lord, for three transgressions of Edom, and for four, I will not turn away the punishment thereof, because he did pursue his brother with the sword, and did cast off all pity, and his anger did stay perpetually, and he kept his wrath forever." Remember that the Edomites were the descendants of Esau, Israel's brother. When the children of Israel needed to pass through the land of Edom on their way to the promised land, they would not let them pass through because they had not forgotten what Jacob did to their forefather several years before. It is a dangerous thing for you to hold grudges or fight against your brother. God frowns seriously at those who do that. 1 John 3:14 and 15, "We know that we have passed from death unto life because we love the brethren. He that loveth not his brother abideth in death. Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer, and ye know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him." If you hate your brethren, you are on your way to hell, no matter how long you have been a Christian, and no matter what service you are rendering to God. God can punish people both now and in eternity for treating their brothers wrongly. The brotherly covenant is a very strong covenant that God respects. We don't want God to punish us because he is God and nobody can escape from his hands when he decides to strike. Therefore, let us always remember and respect the brotherly covenant. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Amen.